Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado. And I want to talk today about money mindset. It's a big one and it's an important one. If you truly want a different way of life than the way you have now, you have to change what's going on in here about money. Now, I went to Millionaire Mindset. If you ever had the opportunity to go, it's Harv, I can't remember his last name. He's a millionaire, multi-millionaire, and he came from very poor circumstances, and he teaches the mindset of how important it is to change the thought pattern that is inside of your mind that talks about money. All of us, unless you started out rich, have a poor mindset when it comes to money. Now, I'm going to switch over. We're showing where we are, and I want to switch over to something I just put up. And the reason why is because this will absolutely relate. The biggest thing that keeps us stuck is our money mindset, and I'm working on mine, and I am. And one of the things that I wanted to emphasize today, you can put it under the video or you can put it under this post that I have just put up. What are some of the phrases that you heard as a child or you still hear today from your parents and other people that have influence over you? One of the ones I remember hearing a lot of the time was whenever I would ask for money or something I wanted that cost money, my mother was mainly my parent because my father left us early, and that meant my mother had to go to work, and that meant she had to struggle for money. And so guess what? She said a lot of the same things that I say to myself, and so I have to work on changing those thought patterns. And one of the things that I heard was money doesn't grow on trees. You have to work very hard for your money. It doesn't just come to you. But that's not necessarily true. Now, I don't mean that it drops out of the sky without any effort. Of course not. But when people work hard for their money and they always think it has to come hard, that word hard can actually hurt you. So you don't want to have that thought. What are some of the thoughts that you have in your money mindset that might be standing in the way of you being able to earn money? And as you saw, I actually was sharing that I received $1,000, one-time $1,000 from one of my clients, and I just wanted to emphasize it. Now, I'm not bragging. And you may not have had a result like this before, but that doesn't mean you can't. The really important thing is that you have to actually make a decision that you are going to have a different mindset. And the very first part of that, before you can do anything else, is to become aware of how many times that you actually talk yourself out of things because you have a bad mindset. Do you ever say things like, oh, I can't afford that, immediately, as soon as someone talks about it? Or are you the quickest one to say when somebody gives you an offer? Because if your mindset isn't good, you can't expect any of your prospects to have a good mindset, because you're going to attract to you the people that are a lot like you. So if your mindset is, I can't afford that, or how much is it, immediately, because you're going to immediately come up with a reason why you can't afford it, well then, how do you expect the prospects that you are talking to say yes, and maybe even spend enough money that you can get a sale like this in a one-time shot? What is your mindset telling you that is hurting you? What's hurting you? How do you change your mindset so that you don't have those kinds So you do have some of those sales, like that sale. Now, that doesn't mean that's the best you can do. That just is an example of what can happen if you change your mindset. So I wrote down some things. What was the phrases that your mother used when you asked for something that cost money or money itself? Mine was, money doesn't grow on trees. But there's many of those kind of phrases out there. What are yours? If you heard broke money phrases, they are always inside of you right now. And if they're inside of you, they're causing you to think in a way that does not attract money to you. What can you do to change those phrases whenever somebody says something or says, well, here's the product or service I want to offer you? Because, you know, you're going to get offers just as well as you're going to get prospects that you want to offer to. If you can't feel good, not only about getting money, receiving money, but also spending money, then you're going to be in a bad place to actually start receiving money. When there are offers to you, like my coaching, that someone wants to offer you, and the very first thought in your mind is, I can't afford that, then how are you going to get to a place where people will buy from you? You've got to get rid of that attitude of, I can't afford it. Start thinking about how you can afford it. That doesn't mean it's going to happen today. But if you start thinking today about how you can do things, what kinds of things you want to do, even if it's just a wish right now, you need to change the mindset. What kinds of things do you want to have in your life? I can afford that right now. Thinking in your head. What kind of a bank account do you want to see in your account? I see it in my account right now. You see what I'm saying? It's in my head. I'm starting to change those old programming mindset, money mindsets that were always hurting me, that were keeping me back. I'm changing them today. I'm changing them every day. I'm not allowing the negative, I'm not allowing the broke mindset to override any of the things that I want in my life. I am changing the mindset today. If you don't change the mindset today, your mindset will not allow you to make money. Your mindset will not allow you to receive anything. It will make you stay broke, because that is what you have been programmed to do. If you don't want to stay broke, then you must become aware of what kinds of mindset programming was in your mind all through your life that you need to change right away. What has to change so that you can receive the money that you need to receive? Like, if I offered you a really cool program that only costs $7 one time, would your first response be, oh, I can't afford that? You see what I'm saying? Your first response is going to tell you exactly where you are with your money. If your mindset is shutting you down immediately and telling you that there's no way that even a $7 program one time is going to kill you, and so you absolutely have to say no to it, well, then how can you expect anyone to say yes to you? You have to start changing your mindset. I can afford that. Oh, I want to hear about that, because that's something I could do. See what I mean? Different mindset opens up different possibilities. And when you want to have different possibilities, you really do have to work on the money mindset. The money mindset is actually the most important part of your mindset programming. You can dream all you want to dream, but if your money mindset is broke, it will not change anything. So what in your life do you need to change? What phrases are playing in the background that need to go away and be changed into something positive. What happens when you happen to see a penny on the ground? Do you walk past it because it's probably dirty? Or do you pick it up and actually celebrate it just like it's $1 million? Now, I know that sounds silly, and most people probably don't do anything with that penny. But how many pennies can you pick up off the ground today that means that you have money coming to you that you didn't even have to do anything for except for pick it up? And sure, pennies can be washed. And how many pennies can you save until it actually amounts to something? That's one thing I learned today, and I didn't even think about it. How many pennies can you throw in a penny bank and turn into something of value so that someday you might actually go and take it and make it become something valuable? Think about that. And then on my post right here, or my video you're probably watching right now, make sure and let me know what money phrases have been holding you back, and what are you going to say to yourself instead to change your money mindset today? I want to hear about it. Let me know. And if you found this of any kind of value, please like, comment, and share. And I'll be talking with you again tomorrow. Bye for now. Okay.